DJ Flawless Walrus.
Yo, I'm feeling that gym coach up sight. Six niggas walk in, blasting they dance pace. I one dog skin nigga, 56 inch rope. Wrapped around twice, smashed the Gilligan boat with ice.
So, here we are, live at the fight with the winner of the night. What's your name, son?
My name is Fast Fingers McGee.
All right, Fast Fingers. So, how many hits to the face did you take?
Well, I took a little to the skull. I tried to bob and weave after all of his major moves because I knew he was going for mostly headshots, so I guarded my body more often since my trainer says there's really nothing up there to guard.
All right. You seem a little shaken up. Are you doing okay?
I'm a little shaken up.
Yeah.
But, you know, after this, I'm going on to fight for heavyweight champion. But I think I'm going to do a pretty good job as long as I keep my head straight and my mind to it. And with God on my side, I think I can win that fight.
So how heavy do you have to be the heavyweight champion?
Well, I know it's 260. I'm working on it. I gained a little bit more muscle mass since the last class. I think I'm at a 200 right now, so I'm still at a middleweight.
At a middleweight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, how do you plan to bring yourself up?
I'm planning on taking a lot of whey protein and working out at the gym with my trainer.
So, no cupcakes?
No.
Yeah.
There's too much fat and grams and all that stuff, so I can't really...
Grams. Yes. But isn't that what you want to gain? More fat? That'll bring up your weight, right?
Well, that's a misconception. You want to gain muscle mass. You don't want to gain fat. See, fat is less dense. Muscle is more dense. So the weight of muscle actually, compared to the weight of fat, gives you more strength.
For someone who takes a lot of hits to the head, you're pretty smart.
I was a lot smart. I used to be a doctor. I was very smart before I became a boxer. But all the punches to the head had brought my IQ down to like 120. So I'm just mediocrely smart now.
So,
is mediocrely a word? I don't know anymore.
I don't know either. What made you decide to go from being a doctor to a boxer?
Well, I used to work with a doctor who was a proctologist who was dyslexic. And I was the best dentist in my field. But he kept switching, you know, with his dyslexia. I was in room 69, he was in 96, and we just kept switching rooms, and it just drove me crazy, and I wanted to hit him so bad. So I went to the gym, and I'm like, I'm gonna learn, one day I'm just gonna go up and just hit this guy, but I knew that I'd get arrested since, you know, I come from a family of lawyers and doctors. Very smart family. So, you know, I went to the gym, trained for a bit, and the guy's like, Skippery-doo, you should try boxing. And I'm like, all right, I'll gain a good 67 pounds and jump in the ring and see what I can do.
Well, Skippery-doo. That's what he said, really? Skippery-doo.
I may have embellished the conversation a bit.
Not something you want to joke around with, a word like Skippery-doo. So, what does your family think about your decision to switch from being a doctor to taking pills to the head?
Coming from an intellectual family, they weren't too proud. They kind of think that, you know, the boxers and anybody that deal with, you know, fighting, it's just kind of a lower class thing.
So,
but, you know, it's my life, and I say, Hickory Doc, I can live the way I want to live.
Hickory Doc.
Yo, I think I did it.